We have all been there. Maybe you've been outside being productive, touching some grass, or maybe you're sitting on your computer playing Helldivers 2 or whatever the kids play these days. But sooner or later, the urge for the mines will come back. That urge to play Minecraft for 2 weeks. Or in my case, it will turn into a month. Recently, I got that urge to play some Minecraft after playing hours of Valorant and wanting to rip my hair out. And some of my friends had started a server with a mod pack on it, and I'd seen them play it and stream it a couple times, and it looked really fun. And after me asking a couple times, they reluctantly said, sure, come on, I guess. So now here we are. I've been playing it for about a week or so, a couple weeks maybe. I initially just thought I'm just gonna play Minecraft for a little bit and then get tired of it, but no, that's not the case. The mod pack is called Valhesia 6. It's got a bunch of mods, like it's got Create mod, it's got Ars Nouveau. There's so many that I'm forgetting all the names right now. My mind is literally drawing a blank, but I'm sure we'll talk about them as the videos go on. If you like this video or like this series, let me know down in the comments down below by hitting that like button, leaving me a comment, or even considering subscribing. It helps out the channel a bunch, and I'd really appreciate it. Okay, so this here is our world spawn. I thought I'd start off kind of right where the world first started, just to show you what my talented and extremely creative friends have made. I'm going to leave a link to everyone's either Twitches or YouTubes down below. Just in case you want to check them out, because they also stream on this world as well. Yeah, this is our little spawn village. We have a massive public portal right there that I have traveled to a few times. But honestly, it's more just for decoration, I feel like. I feel like no one really uses it as like a main portal. But up here is going to be our little portals to some of our bases. And this is mine. You can see right there. There's my little John's factory. So let's go hop on through this and turn around, and it's not nearly as creative or extravagant as our spawn world, but you know what? It's home. Okay, let's go down into John's factory. It's not the prettiest looking place by any means, but it's where I started first kind of experimenting with Create and such. So let me show you what I've built first, and I'll take you through the tour of the rest of the place. This is my little cobblestone generator here. It's all kind of encased. It's actually not turned on right now because we have so much stone that I don't know what to do with. Or the cobblestone gets mined, then comes onto this conveyor belt, then gets cooked, and then comes into here where it's kind of like a little holding chest. And then from there, it goes into there. Yeah, it's a whole thing. This is my little iron ingot stamper, so that I didn't have to do it by hand anymore. I've got some cauldrons with some lava over here. I need to actually, this reminds me. He's just here. I don't know how he got here. He just showed up one day and he's not paying rent, but he's not hurting anything. So I'm just going to leave him. You get to live for now. I need to put lava up here so that I get some more lava. Then I started just expanding. This is my little storage wall. It's not super organized, but it's organized enough. I have things organized by block type and some just assorted mods. I have blocks and items. This is where my Create stuff is. I have a little workspace area over here. This mod pack has Tetra in it, so I have my little Tetra workbench. And there's my Nether portal, which in hindsight is kind of annoying to have it so close to everything because I'm down in this exact spot a lot. So I might be moving that in the future. And then down here, this is really the first big contraption I made, just kind of by messing around. I have a sweet roll factory. Up top, I have a wheat farm that then comes down in here. The wheat gets milled and then washed and then cooked and then turns into bread. And then, as you can hear, I have a cow back here. The cow is providing milk that then comes down and it makes the bread turn into sweet rolls. So I have infinite food supply. That's kind of what my first big task was like, make sure I have unlimited food. Over here is just the other side of my storage wall. This is my automatic andesite and brass casing machine, so that I didn't have to do that part anymore. And this is just kind of, I have this, there's a water wheel stuck back here where I was kind of just messing around doing some testing. But currently right now, it just sits kind of vacant. Let's go show you the outside. So up here is a couple of my farms. Again, these are just basic farms. They're not min-maxed, optimized, perfectly running machines. They are just kind of what I started to experiment with. So this is our little wheat farm here. Over here is our tree farm. And then this is the latest thing I've built on this server, which is a glass and sand factory. Again, not super optimized, but just kind of messing around with it and not really decorated at all. Just kind of thrown together. Basically, we have a cobblestone generator that makes cobble, and then it takes the cobble and crushes it into gravel, and then it gets crushed again, turns into sand, and then sand drops down here, and it goes through this little conveyor belt here that is hooked up to some storage drawers, which these hold, I believe it's 32 of one item, the whole 32 stacks of one item. And so these go into this controller, and since these are only able to take one item, I have it set to sand and then glass for all these other boxes. Once this is full, it will only take glass, so they won't go anywhere. They stop there, and then they get cooked, and then they automatically get put in. So currently just have that making a bunch of glass. What do I need that much glass for? Probably nothing. Down here is another set of contraptions that someone on the server requested. It's a automatic book farm / maker. It doesn't really feel like a factory because it's kind of open air. But this is flax, which is from supplementaries, which can be used in place of leather to make paper. Or not to make paper, to make books. Basically, this is harvesting flax. It goes down underground where I have a stamper that stamps them into, I believe it's a stamper. I don't quite remember, actually. Basically takes the flax and turns it into canvas. And then canvas comes back up here via this chute that's all underground and hidden. And then this actually is not working at the moment. But this is just a sugarcane farm that I had to take the sugarcane. That would then come over here. It would get stamped and turned into paper, and then come over here and get mixed into books. And yeah, I have almost 4 stacks of books, all automatically and not by hand. So that's pretty nice, but that sugarcane farm is currently not working. So at some point I would like to redo that. But yeah, that's the tour of my little base that I've made so far. Again, this is all just kind of me messing around, not really knowing exactly what I'm doing, but I'm hoping now that I've got most of the basics of Create down, I can go and make a much better and more optimized factory than what I have right now. So this is kind of going to operate as our base of operations for our future expansion. That's really the main plan here, is because right now, I don't know if you've noticed, but we're kind of on the side of a mountain. There's not a whole lot of flat land, and Create contraptions need a lot of flat land, I feel like. It'd be optimal to work in a area that is mostly flat, and this area is not that. So I'm planning on having this area be, you know, factory number one, and then make a base somewhere in the grand expanse that is the server. There's a lot of hills around us, but I'm hoping to go and find a nice flat area and create the ultimate Create factory. So let's get some blocks together, let's get some stuff together, and let's go exploring, shall we? So to go on an adventure, I'm gonna need some tools, and thankfully I already have some tools made. I just a bunch of compressed iron and some kind of basic tools I've been rocking with. Nothing too terribly crazy. We also have some I forget what this mod is called, but we have some equipable items, if you will. We have like the engineer's goggles from Create. I have a necklace, which increases the length of invincibility after taking damage. I believe it's artifacts. That makes sense. I have a backpack. I have some iron gloves, and then I have a crystal heart, which increases my hearts, and a totem of undying. If I'm going to go out, I should probably take my boat. That's probably the best mode of transportation. If I can just bloody find where I put it. Where is my
boat.
I had to just make another boat. I'm probably looking right past it. Yep, I'm probably looking right past it, but I'm just gonna make another one because I have so much wood. Does it really matter? That's not how you make a boat. That's how you make a boat. Let me take some cobblestone and maybe some dirt. All right. Keep an eye on my llama, will you? And don't wait up. And what way is not explored? These are all other people's little bases and stuff that everyone's marked on the map. I think I might try and go out that way. Or honestly, I could go this way. No one's been over here. I don't see any markers over here. We're gonna go east. Let us go east. Onward onto the horizon. Okay, so after exploring to the east for many, many blocks and not finding anything useful, I decided to circle back and maybe check around some of the areas that I hadn't explored near where my first base was. And lo and behold, this awesome little spot came up. There's a little village over here. There's a nice wide open space here. And it's not too far from where our base has been built. And it's kind of close to where other people have built their bases as well. So in the future, if we ever want to connect up, maybe make a train system or a monorail system to other places around the server, we're kind of centrally located. So this is where we are going to start. And I think I'm going to build down here for the first building, which is really just going to be our little kind of basic workshop hut. Maybe I'll put it right here. It's pretty good. I can fill this in and kind of make a little platform. And then kind of expand outwards as needed. So let's run back to get some blocks and we'll come back and set up shop. Oh, I'm already out already. Oh, that was fast. I'm gonna need more dirt. Now that we've got the area kind of cleared out, let's put down some blocks here. And I think I'm going to start off with some of the cobblestone brick. Actually, we're going to start with the dark oak. And I'm just going to frame out the building here. I'm going to go there. We'll go here. We'll come out this way. It's just going to be kind of a nice open area. This is really going to be where most of our tools are kept and just kind of our initial crafting areas. So let's just make it nice and square right now. It doesn't need to be anything too fancy. And then we can put the doorway maybe there. Yeah, I like that. I just want to kind of make it flat at the top. Yeah, there we go. Okay, next I need to add the windows. Now that that's done, let's add some windows and get some natural light going in this place. We can put a big one right here. We can put another big one right here. Another one right here. These would be nice big windows letting lots of natural light. Make it not feel as kind of confined. We'll do little square ones right here. Actually, let's move this over one. And then we'll do another one in that same kind of pattern right there. Perfect. I want to make framed glass. I don't know how to do that though. You make framed glass. It's just, stone cutting. All right, and then if we put some of this here, this framed glass looks really good. It's got this nice, like, kind of thicker texture here. If we do that, perfect. Let's put some flooring in. One of the cool mods in this pack is called Rechiseled, which basically adds this chisel, and you can put a vanilla block into it, and then you can get a lot of these other cool patterns out of that same one that you wouldn't normally be able to get. So I think I want to use one of these ones. I don't know what we should use. Maybe we can use this. We can turn connector textures on. We can even preview what it would look like. I kind of like this pattern here. It's a little bit thicker than the regular plank. So we're going to make that. And then I believe they should connect. Yeah, look at that. And it's just, it adds a little bit of, you know, it's same but different feeling. Because like it's, they're just oak planks, but they look, the fact that they look different just makes them feel, it makes it feel better. Look at that. That looks so good. All right. After much trial and error and scavenging for new blocks because I ran out of blocks, we've got our first little building of our new home, our new start out here. Got nothing really inside of it. I just put down some basic workbenches. I got my Tetra workbench. I have a chest that I can use. I have a bed so that we can sleep through the night. You might notice the waystone outside. I'm gonna use that temporarily for traveling to and from my old factory, and then in the future I would like to make a network or a minecart network or some kind of way to travel to and from without having to use teleportation, because of course reason the create mod, there's a way cooler way to get there than just teleporting back and forth. So that's going to be in the future, though. The question is, now what do I build? What's our first create contraption we want out here? Maybe it's food. Maybe we can use all this extra space to make a nice big wheat farm or some kind of automated farm. Or maybe we can get a cobblestone generator up and going, so then I have more raw materials to use over here. Let me know down in the comments down below what you think we should build first. I'm thinking a farm. I think that's definitely something we're going to need. And I'd like to make a bigger one than the little tiny one I built before when I was just kind of messing around first with Create. So I think we have all this area here that would be perfect for that. But that's going to have to be in the next one. Hit that like button if you like this video. Leave a comment down below on ideas or suggestions we should build. And hit that subscribe button if you don't want to miss the next video. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace. Ce serait un isolement minimum.